through that, you build the networks, you get to know people. There's, you know, through secondments, through working abroad, you've got somebody you can pull on. And the role I'm in now, sort of centrally in R&D, I have to use that network a lot. And I do, and it works really well. I can call Lawrence because I knew Lawrence 10 years ago when I joined at Colworth. I can, you know, I've got to know Matt over the last couple of, over the last few months, probably more so. Yeah. And but those networks form and they're great, and you hold on to them. And that's actually a key thing for Unilever. I think it's a differentiator. It makes it quite... It makes it fun to work in.
I've had the benefit of working with a broad cross-section of agencies. I've worked with digital agencies. I've worked with the big advertising agencies. I've worked with the small little hot shops who create the niche ads or the niche little campaigns. I think underpinning all of them, the challenge is identical, and that is having the clarity, we as a client, having the clarity, the specificity, and the ambition to pursue great work, and then you need to inspire them. So, yes, they may be suppliers per se, but they're no different than the people who work for you. If you put me beside another Unilever person who's been here the same amount of time in the same type of role, we would not look like we work for the same company. We would not look like the same type of people. But if you peel back the onion a little bit, I think there's a heartbeat inside of both of us that is pretty consistent because at the end of the day, we're both working for the same objective with the same values and based on the same principles.
Since we are delivering to a global audience, it makes us conscious of all the different cultures whom we are aiming at, you know, whatever we're doing, we're aiming at. And so it makes our output much better. But I think one of the things that my team had done, which was really sweet, was that it was Diwali last year and it wasn't a holiday here and it was in India. So they were feeling bad that I couldn't be at home celebrating with my family. So they decorated my desk and there were lots of ribbons and balloons and it said Happy Diwali to me. And it was really sweet because then everybody else on the floor was wishing me for Diwali, which made me feel very touched. So it was really nice.
It's the challenge of being a technical specialist, but being able to communicate your technical specialism to people that aren't technical specialists. Yeah. Because of course, it's when everything comes together that you get all of the big bang. And when we're interviewing people, we're really looking for people with that extra something, those people that are able to communicate, that are able to be passionate and enthusiastic about their work and explain what they're doing, because that's absolutely crucial, especially in such a technical function.
I actually bring the quality community together, so I actually work generally with probably about 50 quality people across the... across Europe. I think sometimes often the darkest times turn into the highlight when you have significant issues that you need to resolve as a business because that tends to pull people together and focus people.